Smita Sharma. You can see she was still going around and trying to train the kids. So she's a choreographer, dance choreographer as well. So let's give her a big round of applause. Now, we did have one speech, but the speech has been cancelled. So I'm going to move forward straight on to our next performance. Again, as like I mentioned in the beginning, today we are celebrating culture heritage of Nepal, along with celebrating Buddha's birthday. So now here I present you with our next performance is another group dance which embodies the message of peace and also asking in their lyrics. The song says, how can we preserve peace? Where can we find peace? When there is so much of war, tears and violence going on in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, please prepare yourself to be mesmerized by the wonderful performance once again from the team of BAS, Music of Fine Arts and Academy.
Amen. शान्ति लुकाउँ कहाँ
काडै काड जतात तै राखु पाउ कहाँ
थोरै मात्र बचेको यो शान्ति लुकाउँ
Can I have a big hippie hip hooray for this team, please? हजुरहरूलाई कस्तो लागिरहेछ आजको कार्यक्रम? अच्छा छ, राम्रो छ. वान्स अगेन अ बिग बिग राउन्ड अप्लाज अगेन फर बाज टिम फर दिस वन्डरफुल वन्डरफुल ब्युटिफुल ग्रेसफुल पिसफुल. इट वाज मिक्सचर अफ एभ्रिथिङ. यु कुड सी द वार गोइङ अन, यु कुड सी दे वर ट्राइङ टु क्रिएट द पिस. सो इट वाज लट अफ काइन्ड अफ इमोसनल रोलर कोस्टर विदिन द कोरियोग्राफी. सो वेल डन, ब्युटिफुल ट्यालेन्टेड our dancers from Baz Academy. Because there has been some change in our program schedule, so it looks like we've been continuously presenting the dance. Here you go once again with another dance, traditional Lahe dance from Nepal, which is culturally rich and visually stunning dance that showcases the artistic skill and cultural heritage of Nepal, Newari community from Nepal. This dance will be performed by Mr. Vinod Chipalu, former president of International Artists Society UK, who celebrates his 25th year of performing Lahe dance throughout the Europe and in United Kingdom and many more other countries. So he is basically, he's a legendary Lahe dancer. Let's welcome Mr. Chipalu on the stage for his vibrant Lahe dance. Vinod ji, Antarashtriya Kalakar Sangko purva adhyaksha hununcha. Wahale harek barsha yes Buddha Jayanti karyakram ra anya bibhinna karyakram haruma afno Lahe nach prastut gardai aunu bhayeko cha ra waha ko yo 25 au barsha wahale Lahe nachnu bhayeko 25 au barsha ko anniversary ho. Waha lai dherai dherai dhanyabad pani bhanna chahanchau ra wahale Europe ka bibhinna desh haruma, London ka bibhinna shahar haruma र अमेरिका, क्यानाडा, अस्ट्रेलियामा पनि उहाँले आफ्नो प्रस्तुति दिइसक्नु भएको छ. लेडिज एन्ड जेन्टलम्यान, हियर वी प्रेजेन्ट यु Lahe डान्स.
Thank you.
Thank you, Binod Chipalu, for the vibrant Lakhe performance, one of the other performance from Newari community. So before I move on to our next, I have is a speech. Before I move on to speech, I can see some of our non-Nepalese friends here. Very much welcome to you all. Please don't forget to go and visit Nepal. You will never regret. So before I move on to the next presentation, I cannot forget our media, press and media who are here today. I would like to briefly announce their name. Navin Pokhrel from Kantipur, Dhruvaraj Aryal from Nepali Link, Bhagirath Yogi from former BBC, Dinesh Pariyar from Radio Rhino, Siva Bhandari and Prakash Kanel from London Nepal News, which they are doing the live broadcast since we started the program, Bachaspati Regmi from Sital Party, Farindra Bhatta and Manju Vandari from Seto Party, Kushal Shrestha from KK Movies, Bimala Sene from Gurkha Channel, and Pramila Rai from BFBS Gurkha Radio. Thank you so much. Without your support, we would not be able to gather this big crowd today. Thank you so much, all our media and press. I know you guys are going to follow up after this program with lovely pictures, videos, and it will be all over the social media. Thank you so much. Now, next I have here is a remark speech. It is my pleasure to invite Guru Khenpo Karma Chulsim for his remark speech on the occasion of Buddha Jayanti.
Buddham saranam gacchami, Dhamman saranam gacchami, Sangham saranam gacchami. First, all of you, hello and namaste to each and everyone. So today we are gathering here with for good cause, good reason. So today we are celebrating Buddha Purnima or Buddha Jayanti. So always we have to remember it is in Baisakh, full moon, Buddha Purnima. It falls in May month and full moon. It's always that not to forget the Buddha Jayanti celebration, happy celebration. So this is more sacred, most of the sacred for million of Buddhist followers to celebrate. This is more important to be aware. So we are here, we all know, so today we are celebrating Buddha Jayanti. Who was Buddha? Buddha was enlightened being who attained enlightenment completely. The Buddha, we related to three things. So Buddha Jayanti is more important. Why is important? The importance is that Buddha took birth in Lumbini. Buddha took attained enlightenment in Bodhgaya. Buddha entered Parinirvana in Kushinagar. So these three is important occasions for all the Buddhists and Buddhism's occasions. So why we celebrate this? So we have to understand, we celebrate that to remembering the Gautam Buddha, Shakyamuni, and his messages, teachings that he left for all the sentient beings, not for the one country, not for the one nation, but for all sentient beings to attain liberation, ultimate enlightenment as a Buddha. He did. So that's the biggest message for everyone in this world. So today we're celebrating Buddha Jayanti. I would like to promote a little environmental conservation. In the ancient and Buddha, during the Buddha time, when Buddha takes birth in Lumbini. So Lumbini is a place, and geographically the country of Nepal. Country of Nepal that we know, Buddha born in Nepal, but Buddha attained enlightenment in Bodh Gaya under the tree, Bodhi tree. And finally, Buddha attained liberation of Parinirvana at Kushinagar. So it shows very clearly the message of environmental conservation. So Buddha took rebirth in under the tree, Buddha attained enlightenment under the tree, Buddha passing into Nirvana under the tree. So this shows message how important environmental conservation. That we know we face environmental, this how we face situation, global warming, we suffer a lot. So it is a time to take action, to take care of environmental or conservation of environmental for the sake of sentient beings or for the young generations. The ancient time, very important. During the Buddha time, when Buddha meditate under the tree, when Buddha gave teaching under the tree. So this is very clear how important is environmental. When all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas and Arhat, they all meditate under the tree. And also the monastery is out of city, and it was a forest. So how important the forest, the lake, the nature, this all environment is important, so much give to us. So today I am just promoting environmental is how important, but the Buddha teaching message is more important. The Buddha gave us four noble truths, char arya satya, dukkha satya, samudaya satya, marga satya, nirodha satya. Char arya satya, char arya satya adhyan avyas garibachi hamila vini buddha jastai samyak sambodhi gyan prapt garn sakincha, sabale mukta hun sakincha dukha bata ra dukha ko karan bata, klesh ra karma kusha kukarma bata sabale mukta paun sakincha. Sabai ko chahana ichha ke bhanyo ni sabailai dukha ko chai chaina, sabale sukha chaeko cha. But we are in counter opposite, so we have to know what to adopt, what to reject. So truth of suffering, truth of cause of suffering, and the truth of path, and truth of liberations. These four noble truths is more important in Buddhism, but not only for the Buddhist people, it's for all sentient beings that we experience suffering. But we have to recognize what is the cause of suffering: attachment, anger, ignorance. These three is a poison, mental poison that we recognize in Buddhism. So this we have to reduce or eliminate or destroy. That's the important. But it's not easy. At least we all can try in our daily life in order to maintain peace, happiness, and to live better life. So today I want to wish you all peace and happiness. May all sentient beings be happy and cause of happiness. May all sentient beings be free from suffering and cause of suffering. May all sentient beings never apart from peace and happiness. May all sentient beings attain fully enlightenment as Buddha Shakyamuni. Jai Buddha. Thank you everyone.
Thank you, Guru Kempo. It is getting hotter and hotter. I'm feeling my head is pounding. Please do not forget to grab a bottle of water. We've been serving free water bottles. Please make sure you hydrate yourself. And again, I would like to thank my nursing colleagues right over there for serving us today. Waving their hand, I can see all the leaders of Nursing Association. Similarly, I can see leaders and president of Nepalese Doctor Association. We are truly, truly grateful for your support here with us today. Of course, without our sponsors, we couldn't contribute anything for this program. I was mentioning in one of the press meet, if we had more budget, the program would be even to another extent. But we managed to perform this in short span of time in collaboration with Embassy of Nepal. We are extremely honored and grateful for your support, Tourism Board Nepal, and Tourism and Culture Ministry Nepal. I would again like to extend my heartfelt gratitude for partner organizations, Embassy of Nepal, sponsors, and most importantly, you all audience on this warm day, coming here with looking beautiful like this is like Nepali ma bhanthe ni hamle char jat 36 parna hajur le agadi basnu bhako guest le dekhnu bhayo chaina tara pachadi farkeer hernu bhane it truly looks like hamro desh ko char jat 36 parna ko phulbari jastai. So now we have another, it's time for performance again, another cultural performance. It is a dance, a folk dance of Nepal. The dance, especially the attires our dancers are wearing and the ornaments, it holds significant festive atmosphere, cultural celebration, while presenting and honoring rich culture and heritage of our country. Here we present you, ladies and gentlemen, a dance which is, the title of the dance is Akasaima Khule Ki Junko. And this dance was choreographed by the dancers themselves. I can recognize one of the dancers is Mrs. UK Nepal. So thank you ladies for this wonderful performance. The stage is all yours. Thank you. that was the folk dance. Especially ladies, mostly I might be wrong, but as far as I know, this is in initially originated as a folk dance, initially originated as a Maruni dance, and the ladies who were wearing the outfit and attire today, so somehow it was representing a Maruni dance as well. Hope you liked the performance. How was it? Colorful, beautiful, elegant. Where is Mrs. UK Nepal team? Can you make some noise for your dancers, please? Thank you so much. Now, this is a, I wouldn't like to say as a musical presentation, but this is a part of music. It's a drum. So we don't have a full acoustic music, but it's only a drum. This is typically from a Newari culture. It's called as Dhime Baja. A Dhime Baja, significant drum in Newari culture, renowned for its vital role in traditional music and celebration. And this drum will be presented to you all here today by Southeast Pasa Pusa UK Guti. This drum is the integral part of Newari culture, often played during festivals and religious ceremony. Dhime Baja, is it ready? There you are, you can hear from somewhere from the background. Please be patient. So the drum has started from among the crowd itself. And this is how exactly this drum is being played in the Newari culture, especially during their festivals and religious and cultural ceremonies. I can see the Newari community coming in their beautiful Newari attire, ladies and all the gentlemen. It truly looks like a celebration going on, and this is how exactly happens during, especially during all the jatras. I know all the Newari community present here can understand what I'm saying. Please give them a big round applause for the Pasa Pusa UK for this lovely presentation. Oh, there you go, along with the Lakhe Naz. Thank you.
हजुर